Schneider, and this is ShellPoint Today for Thursday, January 2nd. On today's show, we're going to preview all of the technology classes coming up in the 2014 Academy. Dr. Andrew Falweller will discuss how to recover from sports injuries, and we'll also be discussing the senior fitness test. Are you up for the challenge? Well, we'll find out in just minutes. But first, today is sign-up day, so peruse your January issue of ShellPoint Life magazine and sign up for your favorite events, activities, starting this morning at 8:15 a.m. Visit or call the Island Service Desk at 454-2282 or the Woodland Service Desk at 454-2054. While you're there, you can also get tickets to the Saturday show featuring the Preservation Hall Jazz Band. Listening to this band is like taking a musical trip to New Orleans to hear the heart and soul of Bourbon Street. The Preservation Hall Jazz Band takes its name from the famous jazz venue in the French Quarter, which started at a tavern during the War of 1812, but has since become the purest jazz experience available in the world. When you hear the band's pianos, trumpets, trombones, clarinets, and banjos, you become a witness to the groundbreaking jazz spirit of Louis Armstrong and Jelly Roll Morton. The Preservation Hall Jazz Band is bringing this musical history to ShellPoint on Saturday at 7:30 p.m. in the church auditorium. Get tickets for you and your family, as well as your friends, for this fun musical evening. And if you haven't yet gotten season tickets for the ShellPoint Concert Series, you still have the opportunity to save money with our Pick 3 option. Purchase the remaining three concerts in the series, and you'll save a total of $15 off the ticket price. Just visit the service desk or call our box office at 454-2067. Now it's a new year, so it's time to get fit. But that means different things to different people. How do you know what you need to exercise? Well, we've developed a free tool to help you in the process. It's called the Senior Fitness Test. After attempting a simple series of exercises, our fitness instructors can help you choose the classes that are right for you. The Senior Fitness Test is free and is being administered in the month of January by appointment only. So call Michelle Smith at 454-2107 to make your simple 20-minute appointment. Let's see the Senior Fitness Test in action.
Hi, I'm Michelle Smith, and I'm here with Melanie Brode. If the Physical Dimension of Life Quest is one of your goals, I've got something in store for you. It's called the Senior Fitness Test. Melanie, what is the Senior Fitness Test?
The Senior Fitness Test is a series of six different exercises that test your lower and upper body strength, your lower and upper body flexibility, your muscular endurance, your cardiovascular endurance, and your balance. It takes about 15 minutes to perform the test. After you do the test, we go to the chart, which is the national norms of people from the age of 60 to 95. We go through the chart for your age and gender, and that way you can determine what your weaknesses are, where you could use improvement, and what your strengths are. I'm here with Ann Herman today, who has taken the Senior Fitness Test, and she's nice enough to demonstrate the six exercises that we do. The first test is called the back scratch test. So I'm gonna have Ann lift up with her right arm and reach as far back as she can with her fingers. She's then gonna take her left arm from behind. At this point, I would measure the distance, and she's touching her fingers, which is above average. And then we would do the other arm the same direction. Good job, Ann.
Thank you.
The next test is lower body flexibility. So I'm gonna have you kick your right leg out, Ann, with your heel down and your toe up. Good, I'd like you to stack one hand on top of the other. Take a big breath in. Exhale, go down as far as you can and to your foot. Inhale, come up. At this point, I would measure again with my stick. She's above average. If she were touching her sock, that too would be above average. So awesome job, Ann. The next test is upper body strength. So women use 5 pounds, men use an 8 pound weight. I'm gonna put this in her dominant hand. She's gonna do as many bicep curls as she can in 30 seconds. And this is more of a speed thing. The next test is to determine your balance and your agility, okay? So the goal is to get up as fast as you can, walk around that cone that's 8 feet away, and sit back down in the shortest amount of time without running. Lower body strength. This is where she would cross her hands at her chest. Her feet are hip width apart, heels are planted. The goal is to get up and out of that chair as many times as you can in 30 seconds. The next test would be the most challenging. It's the 2-minute step test. This is 2 minutes in duration, and her goal is to lift her knees to hip height for 2 minutes. How we count this? Good, she's not holding on. Every time her right foot strikes the floor is how many times I count, and that would determine her endurance. And I think that concludes the 6th test that you would get for the senior fitness test. It only takes about 15 minutes. If you want to get into the specifics or strength training and the agility flexibility, you have to take the senior fitness test to do that.
Melanie, the senior fitness test is a great way to set some strong fitness goals or even challenge yourself to improve a little bit more of where you're currently at. If you're interested in taking the senior fitness test, please give me a phone call at 454-2107. Leave me a message and I will get back to you about scheduling your senior fitness test.
Of course, sometimes we overdo it when we exercise, be it on the golf course, the tennis courts, or even in our daily walk or morning jog. How do we deal with these common sport injuries? We can learn more from orthopedic surgeon Dr. Andrew Falweller, who is coming to ShellPoint to speak on the subject next Thursday, January 9th at 10:15 a.m. in the Social Center. Mary Franklin has this preview.
I'm Mary Franklin here with Dr. Andy Falweller on a Health Connections program coming up on January 9th, which is a Thursday, and Dr. is going to do a presentation on common sports and overuse injury. It's going to take place at 10:15 a.m., and you can sign up at either of the service desks. Thanks for being here today.
Oh, thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
Well, so you are going to cover a very broad topic and over common sports and overuse injury, but it doesn't have to, you don't have to be an athlete to come to your presentation, right?
No, you don't have to be. It's just if you have aches and pains, injuries from overuse, I think you'd mentioned earlier there's a quilter with a hurt shoulder over here. So really most of these injuries actually occur over 40, which is must pass the athletic lifespan of most people. I see a lot of golfing injuries, tennis. You don't have to be necessarily a jogger or a marathon or a triathlete to have these types of injuries.
Okay, so you can have a shuffleboard, pickleball.
Whatever, slip in the shower.
Yes.
We don't have any ice down here, but people slip still.
Okay, all right. Now, I know you do a wide variety of surgeries and so forth, but is it all so invasive, or is the recovery time getting a little quicker?
Not so much any longer. Mm-hmm. We have very minimal ways of entering into the joints and things and fixing things without making such large incisions. We're able to do less damage. Mm-hmm. People recover quicker, less pain, less scarring, better mobility, better return to function at a sooner time interval.
Okay, and of course we have our rehab facility right here that they can come and rehab and get back into the community quickly. What's the number one surgery you do?
I probably do a lot of rotator cuffs, a lot of knees, a lot of shoulders. Those are the two things that we see. Mm-hmm. Probably most commonly across the nation, knee surgery is the most common thing that we see. Knee arthroscopy, which is the minimally invasive surgery on the knee. For people who have knee pain that causes swelling, they can't walk, locking, give way symptoms, we can do minimally invasive surgery on that.
Okay, so I need to make an appointment with you because there's no reason to live with it, right?
No. There's nobody that needs to live with things. We can at least try to do little small things to modify so they can go on with their lifestyle.
That's good. We have an active lifestyle here, that's for sure.
Yes, we do.
One of the things we want to make sure we tell everyone to come with their questions because you love to just bring it home and give them the information that they want.
Lots of times at these presentations, the tendency is to have a canned PowerPoint type presentation, but really the best part I find is the interaction with the patients and the people and just bringing your questions in. It's almost like being in the neighborhood and they stop you in your driveway. Hey, doc, you know, when I do this, it hurts. I'm happy to answer those questions and help ferret out what's going on and point you in the right direction.
Right. Well, and it's been a little over a year since you've been here.
Yes.
Let's remind all the residents of Shell Point, who is Dr. Fulweiler? Where were you born?
Well, all that.
I'm a native Floridian, which there's not a lot of us down here. I spent some time on the East Coast growing up. I'm a Florida State graduate, undergrad. Then I spent some time in Michigan, got my training certificate through Michigan State University.
Okay.
Did a fellowship in Richmond, Virginia in sports medicine, which is really the orthopedic niche of these minimally invasive surgeries.
Right.
Rotator cuffs, knees, things like that.
Okay, all right.
And so I'm back here in Fort Myers now for about 6 years. I've been in practice.
Okay, and you're at the orthopedic surgery in sports medicine?
Yes.
Yeah,
yes.
Right in town.
Yes, we're right. We have a couple locations right there at Riverwalk and downtown South Fort Myers at a sterile location. Actually, believe it or not, we're seeing some patients in LaBelle as well.
Oh, wow. Well, good for you. We're lucky to have you here. We're looking forward to your presentation.
Thank you.
All right. Well, sign up for this event. If you have any aches and pains, come see Dr. Fulweiler, and he'll answer all of your questions. And if you have any bit of hesitation, he'll help you out with any of your concerns. Again, the Health Connections program is called Common Sports and Overuse Injury. It'll just take place on Thursday, January 9th, 10:15 a.m. in the Social Center. For Dr. Fulweiler, I'm Mary Franklin. Make it a happy and healthy day.
All this week, we're previewing the classes of the 2014 Academy of Lifelong Learning. Spots are filling up fast for many of the classes, especially ones that start next week. For example, have you ever experienced math anxiety, or perhaps math apathy, or even math fear? Well, there's no need to harbor ill will against numbers. Math can actually be quite beautiful. Find out at a class called Math for Those Who Never Liked Math, taught by former math instructor Dick Brown of Parkwood. This class begins next Thursday at 9:15 a.m. in the hospitality room of the Village Church. Also beginning next Thursday is a class in story writing offered by David Singer. He can facilitate you bringing your own story to life using the written word. Story writing begins next Thursday at 1 p.m. in the Buttonwood Room at the Woodlands. And then, how about an arts and crafts class which combines two famous aspects of Southwest Florida, shells and flowers? Star Ramsey of Lakewood has made flower bouquets out of shells for 15 years. Learn her techniques by signing up for Shell Flowers starting next Thursday, January 9th at 2 p.m. in the Sable Room at the Woodlands. And that's just the tip of the iceberg, folks. If you're interested in technology, there are dozens of opportunities to get involved with computers, iPads, smartphones, and more. Penny Modrich is here right now with some highlights from the Academy section, Technology Today and Tomorrow.
Hello, everyone. I'm here today with Penny Modrich of Nautilus, and we're talking about Technology Today and Tomorrow, our very special category in the Academy of Lifelong Learning. Thanks for joining me, Penny.
Well, thank you for inviting me, Terry. It's my pleasure.
Well, we're rolling out a new semester, and I think it's a perfect time to put into people's minds the thought of trying something new with technology, the beginning of a semester.
We have a lot of people who are just champing at the bit to get at the new technology. We have a lot of them who received iPads for Christmas gifts and birthday gifts, and they want to learn how to use them.
And there are a lot of people who are kind of afraid. They're like, I don't want to learn new technology. So I have to share my own personal experience. About a year ago when my laptop at home died, I was asking you and Bruce Findlay, our other T3 instructor, what computers you recommended, and you both said, why aren't you going to get an iPad? And I said, well, I can't. I can't learn a new technology right now. And you shamed me into getting an iPad, and I have it. And I love it. I had no idea that this thin little thing that I could take everywhere with me would open up a world to me.
Right. You tuck it in your pocket or your purse, and you're ready to go. Well, we have those residents who have them, and they are afraid of them. And when I tell them, you didn't learn how to ride a bicycle overnight. You know, you had training wheels, it took time. So consider us your training wheels. We help you. And then you learn little by little, and before you know it, you're an expert.
Well, the beauty of this, one of the beauties of this technology, is you start from right now, today. You open it up and you get started. You don't have to know how many megabytes came with something. You don't have to know a history of having used a computer.
Right.
You can know that computers have their own value without a doubt.
Definitely.
But for somebody new to technology, getting an iPhone, you know, where you have this on a smaller basis plus a telephone capability, or getting an iPad, it's there's so much here.
And it's simple technology. It's point and poke and touch.
Yeah.
What do I want? Oh, I want that. Well, that's your normal thing to do. Mm-hmm. I find myself helping someone with a computer, now poking at their screen,
right,
expecting things to happen, and they don't.
It's right, and it's so simple that my little granddaughter at 6 just, you know, within a few minutes, she memorized my password, got
That's
in,
dangerous.
Goes to all of her games, you know, and it's we have to be more like a child. We
yes.
have to say, okay, here's something new. It's going to be fun. Let's yes. try it. What happens when we go like this?
Exactly, just like a child.
Yeah.
I also want to talk about how you and Bruce do teach most of the classes, as I thank you over and over and over again, but something wonderful and something, a problem that you've turned into a solution for us, is that none of this stuff really comes with manuals. You know, we're used to, even a washing machine, you know, it comes with a manual. And this stuff doesn't. So you give everybody in the course a course outline. You have handouts that are fabulous. But you also recommend that people get a user guide, download it.
Yes. Yes, all of our assistants get a user guide, mm-hmm. and we recommend that all students or residents who are going to be students order the user guide, and Bruce cranks them out. He prints them all. I do the running around, get the binders, and do the three-hole punching, and we put them into a beautiful binder for them, and it is from Apple. This is not a knockoff
right.
for dummies or anything like that. This is a true Apple product. And comes right, you can download it from the internet mm-hmm. and print it out yourself. The first one is 139 pages, and that's for the iPad, and the iPhone is 180 pages or something to that effect. There's a lot of printing. We print them two-sided on a laser printer, and they are beautiful.
So I just want to thank you. I mean, we do have a little built-in fee, very minimal, for each of our classes, which goes just to making sure that we have examples of our technology. We own them. Yeah. ShowPoint owns this technology, a couple iPads, so that when people come into some of your beginner classes, they can see if they even want one. They can see what it does. That's not, that's all that is for. But you spend the time and charge only for the cost of printing these manuals, these user guides for everybody. That's fabulous. Mm-hmm. Well, let's talk about it a little bit. People can start right from scratch with you and Bruce in these classes, and you have a couple other instructors too. What is an iPhone? What is an iPad? I mean, that's wonderful. And then you go up to using.
Right. Well, we have the first one, which is the iPad, which also pertains to the iPhone and the iPod Touch. Why do I need one? Will it replace the devices I already have?
Right.
And Bruce is very good at explaining the differences between the old technology, the new technology, and the different branches of the new technology mm-hmm. so that everything, you really get a chance to make your own decision.
Mm-hmm. I can't thank you enough, because you and Bruce go way beyond the call of duty.
Well, you know the saying is that you can't sell something you don't believe in. Well, we truly believe in it. So we're not selling the device, but we're selling the idea. And we're so happy when someone says, I just got a new iPad. How soon are your classes going to start? I had a couple of people ask me, can you sign me up? Mm-hmm. No, I can't sign you up. You have to do it yourself. But it's so nice that they're so eager mm-hmm. to learn.
Well,
it is fabulous.
You.
Well, when can you sign up and when can you get started? The Academy begins January 6th. These people start right at the beginning. They are going on a 10-week marathon. They're going to be offering 20 classes to get you used to the Apple devices, iPods, iPhones, iPads. If you have any classes, you see the instructors' names right in your Academy brochure. They're happy to answer your questions. They're so happy to answer your questions that they've devoted hours to teaching you how to use this technology in the Academy of Lifelong Learning.
Coming up, we're covering all of Thursday's happenings from Resort Services. Then stay tuned for our menu options and Village Church Connections.
Hi, everyone. Thank you for tuning in with the happening segments of ShellPoint TV. My name is Leslie Brand, and I'm here with Bev Chanley. And we are here to talk about the activities going on at ShellPoint today. And just a reminder, today is activity sign-up day. So just make sure that you mark the activities and programs that you want to go to and get to the either service desk to sign up. And at 8 o'clock, we're going to start with Men's Golf Association at the ShellPoint Golf Club. Also at 8 o'clock is the Round Robin Men's Doubles Tennis at the tennis courts at the Woodlands. 9:30 is current events in the game room at the Woodlands. Also at 9:30 is the ladies' match play at the tennis courts at the Woodlands. Paddles Club is at the kayak storage, also at 9:30. And the last 9:30 activity today is Samba, the card game, at the Sable Room. Introduction to beginning line dancing is at 9:45 in the Health Club. And the Susie Q's taking everyone out to Woody's for lunch. It's going to be at 10 o'clock and sign up is required. Basic line dancing is at 10:15 in the Health Club. And here's Bev to tell us about the activities going on this afternoon.
Thank you, Leslie. At 12:45, you'll find Mahjong being played in the library lounge on the island. And then 1:15, the Spot Play Readers, that's ShellPoint's own theater, will be in the Osprey Room on the island. 1:15 is also the time for shuffleboard down at the shuffleboard courts. We jump all the way to 4 o'clock where the seamstress will be here with her weekly service. She'll be in the Osprey Room on the island. And then at 4:30, the Alcoholics Anonymous meeting will be in the Sable Room at the Woodlands. Pinochle will be played in the library lounge on the island at 7 o'clock. And also at 7 o'clock, we have the Trailblazers Bible Study in the game room. Well, we're sure glad you joined us today, and we'll see you back here again tomorrow.
Menus for Thursday. In the Crystal Room, the Crystal Platter is General Zhao's chicken with steamed rice and Asian vegetables. The dinner special is the Crystal Carving Board for $11.95, and the soup of the day is black bean. In the Island Cafe for lunch, enjoy a barbecue beef sandwich with coleslaw for $7.25. For dinner, the special is Thai night for $8.25. Dinner specials in the Palm Grill on Thursday are New York Strip for $19.95, or Scallop Scampi for $16.95. All menus are available 24 hours a day at www.shellpoint.net.
Hi, welcome to Village Church Connections. I'm Andy Hawkins, the senior pastor of the Village Church, and I'm here to invite you to a special opportunity for prayer and reflection that will take place for the entire ShellPoint retirement community at the Social Center tomorrow morning from 9 to noon. It'll be a great way to start the new year, to spend some time simply reflecting on God's goodness and all the blessings that He has for us according to the Scriptures. We'll be doing this as an interdenominational service, and people from a wide variety of backgrounds and Christian denominations will be represented. I'm involved in this activity, as well as Dr. Sue Stranahan, who's on our staff as the chaplain in the pavilion and in the assisted living facilities, who will be sharing and spending some time in prayer as well. We also have Pastor Walter Still of the Peace Lutheran Church, who's going to help us understand, I think, a really creative and valuable way of having the Scriptures speak into our lives, even as we spend some time in prayer and reflection. We'll also spend some time simply listening to God as we have some scriptures that will guide us in that process, and especially we'll have an interesting way of presenting and participating in the Lord's Prayer that I think you'll find quite memorable. I can't think of a better way to start the new year than simply to have an opportunity with your friends and neighbors to spend some time contemplating what God has for each and every one of us during the coming year. And so it's an interdenominational morning of prayer and reflection in the Social Center, 9 to noon, tomorrow morning. That's Friday, January 3rd. And we'll look forward to seeing you there so that we can enjoy this time in the presence of God together. Thank you. Hope to see you there.
We're glad you joined us for today's show. Tune in tomorrow as Tim Lockridge describes a new contract at ShellPoint, which you can take advantage of this year only. Until then, this is ShellPoint Today for Thursday, January 2nd. I'm Lynn Schneider, and from all of us here at ShellPoint TV, I hope you have a great day, and we'll see you again tomorrow.